Right, guys, it's me again, it's Tot. It's been a while since I did any sort of gadget review. So what you have in front of you is the JBL Radial speaker dock for your iPhone and iPod. I was in the market for a hi-fi system. I wasn't prepared to spend more than 150 quid for it, so this unit being 100 quid, it's perfect. I was trying my phone with my variety of music, which basically ranges from shit to really shit. So pop punk, dubstep, metalcore, trance, a bit of acoustic, a bit of classical music, generally none of the stuff that you'd be hearing over the radio, but dubstep. So I compared this against the Bose Sound Dock Series 2 and the Philips Fidelio 8500 series, all of which are over 200 quid. This performs just as well, and to be perfectly honest, it suits the furniture that I have in my room. The black goes well with that. It goes well with pretty much what you see, coffee table and everything like that. My bedroom is pretty much set up in the same way, and that's where this thing intends to live. Got black furniture everywhere and white walls and bedding. Enough of that. The whole purpose of this review or this video is to see how well it performs. Initial impressions at the store was that it performed impeccably right through the entire frequency range, delivering some punchy bass and enough mids and high to ensure that you'd hear the solos and vocals when you listen to metal. A quick overview of 360 of the unit. Got power lead, power button, USB that allows it, when connected to the PC, to act as an iPod sync into your iTunes. You've got an auxiliary in for any sort of other devices, so technically speaking I could run my PC through here. And you've got DS video in to connect to your TV. So without further ado, let's give it a sound test. Hopefully I'll try to control everything through this remote and I'll give you an impression as to how it performs. I've got my mic on my webcam turned all the way down just so that it doesn't clip. Let's have some kill switch engaged to begin with. That's the sort of volume I'd have when I'm sort of working in the background. Turn it a bit down. That sort of bedroom volume. I'm going to show you where the step changes in terms of amplitude. There you go. At that volume, that's where the bass kicks in into the woofer. I believe it's 30 watts in total RMS. Two tweeters and a woofer. It's got enough power behind it to fill in a room, which is exactly what I wanted it for. If anything, this thing can pack a bit of a surprise if you have it set in the corner of your room at a house party. It would hold its own against some of your more established hi-fis. Let's change genre. Let's go to dubstep. Have some Skrillex. I put it at a reasonable volume so that I don't get an asbo from the neighbours. Put it in a drop somewhere. It's not overpowering yet. There you could feel it vibrating the floor. So I don't think that's gonna seldom be at that sort of level. But in terms of capabilities, it does have it. Now, a test of clarity, I'm going to be putting some acoustic. Let's have some bullet for my Valentine. If I can find it. Are that I'm definitely going to get an ASBO if I'm going to be playing this at the volume I would like to play it, because the bass, once you get to that level where I said there was a step change, it literally shakes the room. I could feel the coffee table, which this camera is resting on, shaking, and yeah, you could feel it through my laminate flooring. For £100, if you are looking for a sound dock that looks rather quirky, my personal experience is that this, with the music that I've been playing through it, is more than up for a good fight or two. Man, this review kind of sucks, so I apologise, but there you have it, JBL Radials.